several budgets on the agenda tonight, I think six budgets, and a report. They're called SCIF grants. Wait, is this right? SCIF. So right off the top, let's see if we can agree on anything.
Michael Brown, 956, 11M.
doesn't make we depend upon other investigative selections or the department to assist in the investigation of homicides and other incidents for which we have sued responsibility. So this would obviously would not permit those resources to take action on the primary duties, which may have been, for example, youth, child abuse, domestic violence, drug problem investigation. The situations in the past have impacted those sections for several months at a time. Additionally, members returning from the MCU bring a skill set
sincere thanks to Saanich. The HCP looks forward to continuing this valuable collaboration with Mayor Leonard. And Mayor Leonard, thank you for everything you were offering. You were a shoulder to cry on at times last year, but you were also providing us very, very helpful advice. Members of the council, especially Vicki Saunders, who attended our meetings, you were in her area of responsibility, and she could have been more helpful. And to the rest of the council, the Saanich Council staff, with your grant this year, we will be able to maintain this high standard and reach even greater heights. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mr. Mayor. First of all, congratulations on your progress with the governor. That's exciting. And that's what I appreciate. I'm sure this time last year, that's great news. My wife and I frequently go up to the center, and we're more and more impressed all the time with the diversity of opportunities and activities that's taking place there. I just wonder if it's still kind of the best kept secret in Saanich. I don't mean that in any way. I just mean, is the board looking at a program that really provides something for residents and visitors alike that just says, wow, there's a great place to go on to that problem. And I know I probably a few weeks ago was wondering if the Japanese garden interpreters they like and the rest of the visitors that are there, they're talking, they were saying,
I must say, accountants not to confuse everything. basically, the actual amount is probably closer in the neighborhood of about $300,000. But a lot of that did not go through HCP because the insurance company paid it out for us to continue business. And so that was sort of not under our covered insurance
and our main policy, but it was from the secondary policy. So one of the factors there was we had to rent a tent to hold our different events and weddings and whatnot. And the setup and everything, which was quite expensive to do, the insurance company paid that, and it sort of did not flow through us. So the $200,000 is pretty well what we will reflect in our financials. For your interest, the audit is in progress at the moment. The Institute of Chartered Accountants, which sets the rules for how things are treated. We used to have this marvelous thing on financial statements, income statements, saying called extraordinary items. Something like this fire back in days gone by, we would have extraordinary item, and we would show the proceeds from the gross proceeds from the fire, and then the costs and exactly where the money went. The Institute now no longer allows this. When we have our financial statements, I have requested our auditors to do a detailed note explaining exactly the amounts of money, where they came from, and where they went to. So the exact figure right now is kind of hard to pinpoint because of these factors.
established a number of committees, including the Finance Committee and the Fundraising Committee. We've also established an executive committee to a lot of the decisions forward to a lot quicker. And then we turn to the task of finding the next executive director. So Terry has spent 6.5 years of dedication and knowledge and true deep love for Swanwick. But looking forward, we feel that this is kind of the end of the era. And looking forward, we need to refocus the executive director's position so we can establish a new job description for Swanwick.
first responder program?
The people that we're providing services to, so now with COVID, have they had the same agreement, or are they going to come to our agreement?
Somewhat challenging.
Do you want to wait at the Capitol at all, or? Page 70, I think there's. Answer any questions. There's just one purchase outstanding and a contribution to what the police is on the mobile command unit. Emergency program?
2.5 minutes.
I
hard to go under this table, so I'll take that.